We're asked to describe the inequality x greater than or equal to negative 5 using interval notation and a graph. Let's actually first graph the interval, and then from the graph, we'll write the interval notation. So because we have x greater than or equal to negative 5, negative 5 is in the interval, or is part of the solution. So we make a closed circle or closed point on negative 5. And because it's x greater than or equal to negative 5, we draw an arrow to the right, where values are greater than negative 5. So here's the graph, and now for interval notation, we approach positive infinity to the right, negative infinity to the left. So because our interval is all real numbers, greater than or equal to negative 5, we're going to have negative 5 comma infinity, and then because negative 5 is in the interval, we make a square bracket to the left of negative 5, indicating the endpoint is included. And then for infinity and negative infinity, we always use right in parentheses, so we have a closed parenthesis to the right of infinity. Now we have the inequality as a graph and using interval notation. Let's look at a second example. Here we want to describe the inequality x less than 2, again using interval notation and a graph. Let's first graph the interval. So because x is less than 2, not less than or equal to 2, 2 is not in the interval, so we make an open circle or open point on 2. And because it's x less than 2, we draw an arrow to the left where values are less than 2. This is the graph of the interval. And now for interval notation, to the left we approach negative infinity, to the right positive infinity. So for interval notation, we'll have negative infinity comma 2 to begin. And again, for infinity and negative infinity, we always use a random parenthesis. We have an open parenthesis to the left. And to the right of 2, because 2 is not in the interval, we also use a random parenthesis. So we have a closed parenthesis to the right of 2. We now have the inequality using interval notation and a graph. I hope you found this helpful.